Hello children, in the climate chapter till now we have done factors affecting the climate regarding the southwest monsoon, western cyclonic disturbances, mechanism of the monsoon and the effect of the El Nino on the southern oscillation on the monsoon in the India. Now let's begin with the next topic, that is the onset of the monsoon and the withdrawal. See, the monsoon in the India, its winds are pulsating in nature, that is they are moving in nature. They keeps on moving from the plain areas to the hilly areas and then again coming back to the plain areas. Like this, vice versa, it happens. Its duration is of 100 to 120 days from the early June till mid-September. Burst of the monsoon, what is that, burst of the monsoon? Normal rainfall increases suddenly and continues for the several days, that is called as a burst of the monsoon. You have seen that when the rainfall occurs in the rainy season, it keeps on raining for few days. Then after that, there will be a dry spell. That is, there will be a sunny days. So after that, again rainfall occurs. So this is called as the burst of the monsoon when the rainfall continues for several days. See how the rainfall is caused in the India. This is the southwest monsoon branch, which divides itself into two parts, that is the Arabian Sea branch and the Bay of Bengal. The Arabian Sea branch, comes to India, that is at the June 1st, at the tip of the India, okay? After that, this branch reaches Mumbai on June 10. These are the tentative dates for the monsoon to arrive in India. After that, by June 15, it reaches to the Saurashtra. Saurashtra are the few districts of the Gujarat that are called as Saurashtra. In the meantime, this Bay of Bengal branch of the southwest monsoon moves towards the Assam. Due to the presence of the Himalayas, it strikes the Himalayas. Yahan se takrati hai. Then they turn towards the western side, start moving towards the Ganga plains and gives the rainfall in the parts of the West Bengal, Bihar, Jharkhand, Uttar Pradesh and few parts of Haryana also. Both the branches are same only, they are the branches of southwest monsoon only. So they merge together in the Ganga plains and the northwestern part of the India. At that time, giving rainfall to this part of the India. On June 29, the monsoon reaches Delhi. After that, first week of July, it reaches to the state of Uttar Pradesh, Punjab, Haryana and eastern Rajasthan. Then the mid-July, it reaches to the Himachal Pradesh. So till mid-July, monsoon winds covers the whole of the country. After that, it remains in India till the September. From the September onwards, the monsoon starts withdrawing from the country. Begins with the northwestern states by the early September. Okay, then from the early September, starting of the September, it starts withdrawing from the country, from the northwestern states, that is this part of the country. Then by early October, withdraws from the northern India. This is your northern India, this is your southern India. From the starting of the October, it withdraws from this part of the India. After that, it withdraws from the whole of the country. By December, the monsoon winds are totally withdrawn from whole of the country. In the meantime, our country becomes in the influence of the winter rainfall that are caused in India due to western cyclonic disturbances.